बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द प्रीएम्बल एंड द शॉर्ट टाइटल एंड एक्सटेंड एंड कमेंसमेंट ऑफ द लैंड एक्विजिशन एक्ट 1894. नाउ टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फ्रॉम द सेक्शन 3 डेफिनेशन क्लॉजेस. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द डेफिनेशन क्लॉज, द फर्स्ट एक्सप्रेशन इज लैंड. यूजुअली व्हेन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द लैंड दैट इन कॉमन सेंस are in common language, in common practice, the land only and only includes and means the immovable property and the things which are permanently vested or attached with the immovable property. For example, if we are discussing about the land, the building construction on the land is also considered as immovable property, and this things which has been vested with that, like fan, doors, or standing crops, etc., are also come within the ambit of the immovable property. But in the Land Acquisition Act, because we have to pay compensation to those persons from whom we are going to acquire the land, so that's why land also includes the benefit arise out of that land. For example, if there is any standing crop, or the nature of the land is that from where some other benefits are being arises. Benefits are what? Benefits like coal, or like petrol, or any other thing which has been derived or arises from the land is also included in the definition clause of land in the Land Acquisition Act. And the things attached to the earth are permanently fastened to anything attached to the earth are also called the land. For example, if I am talking about the fan which has been fastened permanently or temporarily with any building, and the building is attached permanently or temporarily with land, then that fan also be deemed as land, right? I cannot say that this is not a land, but I also can refer the doors of a building, doors of a house, standing crops of a landed property, movable property as land, only and only under the Land Acquisition Act. I have no concern with other acts. Clear? Another expression is used in the Land Acquisition Act is person interested. Look, now person interested in what sense? There are two categories of person interested. Number one, from whom the land has been acquired by the government, and another thing, for whom the government has acquired the land. In simple words, for the benefits of persons and from whom the property has been acquired. So these both persons can be categorized as a person interested. If we see the wording of the act, the person interested include all persons claiming an interest and the compensation to be made on account of acquisition under this act, number one, right? Number one, those person may be or shall be interested from whom we have acquired the land, and now they are claiming for the compensation, that is also known as the person interested. Another thing is that, and a person shall deem to be interested in the land if he is interested in an easement affecting the land, or if you are acquiring the land, I have a right of easement, so I will also be deemed as interested person under this act, right? If you acquire this land, from where I will pass or how I will enjoy my rights of the easements, so I will also be deemed as interested person or person interested under the Land Acquisition Act 1894. Thereafter we have collector. The collector of a district means the district officer revenue, and nowadays the senior civil judges of a court are
sir, kindly can you repeat this, sir? I have joined recently.
That's your fault. I will upload the recorded lecture. You may catch the same from that, please.
Acha sir, third party have sir can have a right of easement.
Look, if while I was acquiring the land, government was acquiring. Thoda slow. While I was acquiring the land, if you were enjoying the right of easement, that then you will be deemed as interested person at that land, right? Amir, is it clear to you?
Yeah.
At the time of acquisition, if you were enjoying the right of easement, then you will be deemed as interested person. Otherwise, you will not be deemed as interested person if thereafter, after the acquisition, you are going to claim the right for easement, then you will, that will be the matter of fact and will be determined by the court that whether this person is entitled for the easement or not, but you will not be deemed as, what can we say, person interested, because you will not claim for the compensation against the acquisition made by the government. Because the Land Acquisition Act is totally speaks about the compensation given by the government or the companies to the persons from whom they are acquiring the land for two purposes. Number one, for the public purpose. Another is for the company's purposes. Right?
Okay, sir.
Sir, thoda slow chale. It's a definition class. That's why we are going fastly. When we, inshallah, complete this section 3, thereafter we have interesting topics we will discuss step by step, not through this mere reading. Don't worry about that. Thereafter we have the term court. Here, this was plea of all of the students that teacher going to deliver the lectures in Urdu or Sindhi, and that's why it's not possible for us to give our examination in English. That's why in the very first class I have asked from the class that whether I will use Sindhi, Urdu or English or mixed language. The most of all students responded that you have to use the English language so that we will be able to understand and give exam in the proper way. So where you have any confusion, you may ask. I will translate it. I use another modem of language for you. Don't worry, Mr. Abdul Hamid. So thereafter we have the term court. Court means the principal civil court of original jurisdiction and include the court of additional district judge and civil judge whom the provincial government may appoint by name virtue so also. When we use the term court in the Land Acquisition Act, that means the principal seat of principal court of civil court. Principal civil court is High Court, right? And thereafter we have district court, additional district court, and we have senior civil judges and civil judges. These all can be used as the court under the Land Acquisition Act. Another thing is that if government appoint any person or any judge or any court that you in the province, that in the province of in the district of Hyderabad, you will have to hear the all matters of Land Acquisition Act, then that court will use all the powers and entertain that applications and suits brought by the aggrieved persons. Just give me 1 second, please hold on for one while.